Hi everyone, today's headlines. NTPA urges state government to lift ban on timber export. DOAC issues SOPs for strict compliances. Ex-Assam CM Gogoi dies. COVID-19 worsen in Delhi. AstraZeneca Covaxin can be 90% effective. Nagaland COVID tally rises to 10,852. Border raw. AKM demands intervention of DC Mogachong. North Korea calls for tighter border controls. News in details. NTPA urges state government to lift ban on timber export. Nagaland Tree Planters Association has urged the state government to contemplate on the genuine grievances of the tree farmers and traders of Nagaland and lift the recent ban on timber export. NTPA through its media cell stated that for a state like Nagaland with limited opportunities, timber exports have become essential sources of livelihood for the many. NTPA, however, lamented that in the recent implementation, timber exports had been portrayed negatively as a destructive force rather than an essential force of forestation and element of sustainable development. DOAC issues SOPs for strict compliances. Considering the prevailing COVID-19 situation in the state and in the interest of schools and students' community, the Department of School Education has issued the directives for strict compliances by all schools, both government and private. In a notification, Principal Secretary Menicol John stated that the end-term assessment for class 1 to 7 would be conducted by the respective schools December 2-22, 2020. As per the scheme of examination notified by the competent authority, it stated that end-term assessment for class 1 to 7 would be conducted through online or offline mode, distribution of question paper or collection of answer script in the batches strictly observing the SOPs. Ex-Assam CM Gogoi dies. A pall of gloom descended on Assam as veteran Congress leader and three-time former Chief Minister Tarun Gogoi passed away at Gauri Medical College Hospital here on Monday evening due to post-COVID complications. This was confirmed by the State Health Minister Himanta Biswa Sarma. The Congress veteran was 86 and is survived by his wife Dolly Gogoi, daughter Chandrima and son Gaurav, diagnosed with COVID in August end. Gogoi was administered plasma therapy after his condition deteriorated. Having tested negative later, he was however battling post-COVID complications and was put on non-invasive ventilation on November 2. Before put under invasive ventilation on Saturday as his condition worsened. COVID-19 situation worsened in Delhi. Even as COVID-19 cases rapidly increasing in the national capital, the Supreme Court has said the COVID-19 situation in Delhi has worsened in the last 2 weeks and sought a status report from the Arvind Kejriwal government to examine the bottlenecks in connection with the pandemic management. Things have worsened in Delhi, especially in November. You filed a status report on what steps have been taken. A bench headed by Justice Ashok Bhushan, Solicitor General Sanjay Jain, who was appearing for Delhi government. Jain told the bench that, as per earlier order of the Apex Court, expert committee has been constituted and other directives have also been compiled with the Delhi government. He said that a separate space has been earmarked for cremation of 385 bodies. AstraZeneca Covaxin can be 90% effective. Britain's AstraZeneca said on Monday its vaccine for the novel coronavirus could be around 90% effective without any serious side effects, giving the world another important tool to halt the COVID-19 pandemic. The vaccine developed by Oxford University was 90% effective in preventing COVID-19 when it was administered as a half dose followed by a full dose at least 1 month apart, according to data from the last stage trials in Britain and Brazil. No serious safety events related to vaccine have been confirmed and it was well tolerated across both dosing regimens, it said. Nagaland COVID-19 tally rises to 10,852. COVID-19 caseload in Nagaland rose to 10,852 after 75 positive cases were detected on Monday. 51 in Dimapur, 18 in Kohima, 5 in Tunzang and 1 in Mon. Border row, AKM demands intervention of DC Mogachong. Our Students Association has demanded the immediate intervention of Deputy Commissioner Mogachong in the ongoing border tension along Assam-Nagaland border in the district. It may be noted that the ongoing ban on Mogachong district imposed by various organizations since November 15 has caused tremendous dislocation of trade and commerce in Mogachong district. Besides affecting nearby districts such as Longleng, Kyunzang, Zunabato, and Kifri. North Korea calls for tighter border controls. North Korea has called for tighter border controls against the coronavirus pandemic, urging its officials to stay on high alert at all times, amid a global resurgence of new cases, state media reported. North Korea has intensified calls for tightened preventive measures against the pandemic after leader Kim Jong held a Politburo meeting of the Workers' Party and stressed the need to keep a high alert, build a tight blocking wall, and further intensify the anti-epidemic work. That's all for now. To get the latest news, don't forget to subscribe to this channel. Thank you.